Hello and welcome to this On Demand event today. My name is John Cheek. I'm here from UniTasterDays, and with these guides, we provide instructions to studying different subjects at university. And then today we're going to look at natural sciences, and I'm absolutely delighted to be joined by Megan Wright from the University of Leeds to have that discussion. So Megan, do you mind if I start just by asking you to tell us a little bit more about yourself?
Yeah, sure. So thanks for having me. So my name's Megan. I'm a lecturer in the Department of Chemistry at the University of Leeds. And I'm also a deputy program manager for our natural sciences degree. So that means I help manage the program and support our students. And my kind of area of interest in research and teaching is chemical biology. So the interface between chemistry and biology. And I am, in fact, also a graduate of a natural sciences degree program myself.
Thank you so much. Right, I'm going to come to you with the first question. I'm a bit concerned by asking this question. I'm going to show that my level of knowledge is pretty poor, but I'm going to have to ask it. So natural sciences, Megan, do you mind just telling me what it is?
Sure. So natural sciences is where you study multiple sciences at university, and different unis have very different sort of degree structures, but usually you kind of start out fairly broad, studying maybe three different sciences, and then often you have the opportunity to specialize, and the degree to which you do that just depends on the course. And what we mean by the kind of the sciences, usually the kind of typical subjects of chemistry, physics, biology, sometimes biochemistry or pharmacology are separate subjects. And sometimes also subjects like food science and nutrition or environmental sciences are in there as well. So it's sort of like a joint honours degree, but across even more subjects.
Thank you. And I'm so glad I asked because, I learned a lot straight from the answer, and no doubt we're going to learn a lot as we go through. Right then, so now we know what natural sciences is. Do you mind just telling us why, like, for a student that's watching this video, why they might be interested in considering studying it?
Yeah, so I think there are a few reasons. So one, as a student, you might be thinking, well, I love multiple sciences. I'm really interested in multiple sciences, and I'm not sure which one I want to study in my degree. And so natural sciences can be a great option there because you're exploring multiple subjects, and then you often get the chance to kind of focus in later. It might also be that you're really interested in an area that's kind of at the boundary between sciences. So maybe the climate and our atmosphere of our world. And in that case, chemistry is very relevant because there's all kinds of chemistry happening in the atmosphere. But then so is environmental science. So you might, if you're very interested in that kind of interface, you might choose to do a natural sciences degree so that you can sort of study the relevant subjects for your area of interest. So those are the kind of two main reasons that people are interested in natural sciences. I think there are lots of good reasons to study the degree. I think the first one, and it sounds kind of a bit trite really, but nature doesn't sort of subdivide the world into physics and chemistry and biology. And many of the big problems we face as a society aren't going to be solved by one single discipline. So I think natural scientists who have that kind of depth of knowledge in multiple sciences and can communicate across multiple sciences and think in different ways are really sought after and really well placed to kind of tackle those problems. And then I think the final thing is that, lots of the really exciting science and really exciting discoveries that happen in science happen at these kind of boundaries between disciplines. So applying knowledge from one discipline in another discipline. So an example is sort of directed evolution, which won a Nobel Prize a few years ago. And this topic is about inventing new enzymes that can do things that nature can't do. And it's this way of doing that. And these enzymes have ended up in our washing powders, so they're better at doing things that natural enzymes can't do. And this field was basically developed and invented by someone coming from a chemical engineer and looking at a biological problem. So I think there are lots of ways in which natural scientists can contribute to big societal challenges.
The next thing I want to do is explore what a student can expect if they study natural sciences. So do you mind just giving us a snapshot about what to expect on a natural sciences degree?
Yeah, so you'll be studying multiple sciences in depth. Usually those are taught by the individual departments. So you'd be, if you were doing, say, physics, chemistry and maths, then you'd be doing chemistry alongside the people doing chemistry degrees, taught by the chemistry department, and the same for physics and the same for maths. And that's because, so then you're taught by the experts. So you'll be kind of balancing these different subjects. And if you're doing experimental sciences, then that will usually mean that you're doing labs. And then there's all the kind of usual ways of teaching that come in to uni life. So large groups in lectures and maybe also large group problem sessions like workshops, smaller group teaching like tutorials. So you'd have a mix of these, maybe some little bit of online content as well, where you learn something yourself independently and then come into a session and discuss it. So lots of different modes of teaching.
Thanks, Megan. Right. You mentioned about kind of the different subjects that you might encounter. And I noticed when I was doing a bit of research before this, your job title is an Associate Professor of Chemical Biology. So do you tend to lean more towards the chemistry and biology side?
I do, yeah, that's exactly right. So I did a natural sciences degree I started out with physics, chemistry, biology, and I ended up more focusing on chemistry and biology and then on chemistry. And yeah, my interest is in how we apply chemistry to understand biological problems. So I sit in a chemistry department, but a lot of what we do in research is biology as well, and we also work really closely with biologists.
You know, the point you made before about kind of crossing between subjects is that you are a prime example of that, where you're kind of looking at two distinct areas. Right, so students now have found out a little bit more about what natural science is, what to expect on the course, why they might want to consider it. So if they then are thinking, yes, I want to apply, is there anything that you particularly like to see in an application or in a student on the program? Any tips there?
Yeah, so I think we're looking for someone who, you know, to articulate why it is that multiple sciences attract you. What is it that motivates you? And it may well be, I mean, this is what motivated me, was I couldn't decide which science I like best. I had a broad interest. So showing that you have that kind of broad interest, or that you have a very specific interest and that's why you want to study these, study natural sciences, study multiple subjects. Yeah, so we typically, applicants have A-levels or equivalent in multiple sciences. You'll need to look at kind of the prerequisites that you'll need. So very often, for example, to study physics, you'll need maths. Very often to study biochemistry, you'll actually need chemistry. So kind of looking at those details and understanding whether you kind of have those requirements. Very often degrees have variants, like they might have come as a bachelor's and also an integrated master's. They might also have the possibility to do a year abroad or a year in industry. And so looking at all of these things, and if that is something that is really excites you, then kind of bringing that, coming up, showing that across in your application.
So the last question I always like to ask is to get a grasp on careers. Now, some subjects, it's probably really easy for speakers to talk about, you know, careers because there's one direct route. This one, I'm guessing, might be more challenging. But do you mind just giving us an overview of what careers graduates of natural sciences go on to do?
Yeah, so as you've kind of suggested, it is very broad. So say you specialised and majored in chemistry with biochemistry, then obviously you could go into scientific careers associated with chemistry, or into teaching chemistry, as well as possibly biochemistry, if you had kind of had enough there. But our natural scientists go into all kinds of different things. So just to give you an example, at Leeds, we've got some statistics saying that about a third of our natural scientists go on to further studies. That's quite a high number, so PhDs or master's degrees. About a third end up in sort of science or science-related roles. So that can be, you know, technical roles in labs, that can be working in all kinds of companies, big pharma, biotech, engineering companies. Lots of people go into IT and sort of dealing with big data, and then all kinds of other professions as well. So teaching, patent law, marketing, kind of the list goes on. I think one of the things a natural sciences degree gives you is not only those kind of critical thinking skills that you develop through a science degree, but also this ability to communicate and use ideas from one subject in another subject. And these are very transferable skills that employers really like to see.
This has been such a useful conversation. And honestly, the next time I speak to a student that isn't sure whether they want to do a certain science subject or another one, natural sciences is going to be the forefront of my mind when I speak to them. So I've learnt loads, and no doubt the listeners of this video have learnt loads as well. So the final thing for me to say is, Megan Wright, joining us from the University of Leeds. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.